So welcome, dear learners. Today we have with us Professor Bielsa, Director HRDC, Kumaon University, Nainital. He has got a very rich research experience. So we would like to have his expert comments with us. So Professor Sir, welcome.
Thank you.
In our course in academic writing. So we would like to have your expert comment regarding the academic writing with respect to the arts and humanities, sir. What do you think, sir?
Okay. First of all, I thank you for calling me and praising me so much. So I am not so much academically sound, but still, yes, you raised a very good question. Because in social sciences, in humanities, and especially in languages, you know, academic writing is a difficult thing. Due to variety of reasons, especially because we do not much focus on, especially on review of literature, referencing methods and methodology. Many a time in so many languages, especially in Hindi, English, Sanskrit, whatever it may be, and even in social sciences, I am unable to understand why they do not give so much of preference to especially objectives, hypotheses, or research questions. They do not try to gel these things which are so important for doing any good academic writing, because writing is very simple, you know. For example, I was quoting to you yesterday also, you know, the Kabir wrote so very good, you know, couplets, you know. He was never read any this mythology research or whatever you yeah, say, or academic writing, you know,
yes,
for that matter. But he was relevant at that time also, this time also, in future also. That is the magnanimity of his you know, thought process. So as this thought process comes, how we are going to translate it into the academic writing, this is a very, very big challenge. I am happy that you have you are doing 1-3 day this workshop as far as the academic writings are concerned. I believe that everyone, whosoever is attending over here, they will be beneficiary out of that, and they will understand the small nitty-gritties, because in social sciences I have not seen that if you ask them what is the proposal, what is the synopsis, they will not be able to give the difference, what is the topic, what is the title, they are not going to, what is summary, what is abstract. So many things like that, this small nitty-gritties, they do not understand. When they do not understand, then they are unable to come up to the standard of writing, especially academic writing, which we are looking for in this 21st century.
Sir, one thing I would like to ask you, that in sciences, what we people do, we if you are evaluating in quality of a paper, we go with the impact factor.
Right.
We
right,
go
right,
with right. The, okay, this is the site, number of citation. What about the social sciences and arts and humanities? How will you judge the quality of paper there?
Here, the quality of people, you know, if they are really very, very innovative and creative, and they are able to come up with some different ideas and notions, naturally their quality will go ahead of anything, you know. So that is another one crisis, though people are doing some you know, work like that. But in our, because you are time and again we are focusing on academic writing, in our academics people are not doing, the people who are not in the universities or colleges or in academic area, they are doing, but we are unable to do so. If you go to the, at least I can talk about the Indian perspective point of view, they are not doing. That is again a big question. So therefore I believe this type of workshops and seminars is required.
So I would like to make you feel free. The expert comments regarding the academy writing, you want to give your message for the arts and humanities and the social sciences researchers. What should they do to inculcate the academic writing skills? What are the good best practices, you say, sir?
I always believe in that, first of all, they catch hold of the keywords, which are very important. If they are doing, coming up with any title, they should know what keywords and why they are putting that keyword. And they should, and they must understand what is the qualitative and quantitative difference, and how, if you want to gel these things, how you can gel. For example, many a time I have seen they do case study, but I do not know whether they are doing it as a methodology or as a method. So in case study, research methodology is a little different, research method is a little different, and in a similar way, they should understand what is just writing, academic writing, and especially how the referencing goes, you know. They
nowadays, you know, they are not much bothered about the, you know, the citation and all. I am not much bothered about the this referencing and all. For academic writing, I do believe that review of literature and, you know, the research citation, how it will go, how the referencing will go, these are very, very important thing which they, and especially ultimately manuscript writing, or they, once they write their their manuscript, how they are going to write, what are the do's and don'ts they should keep in their mind. If they will not keep these things in their mind, I think that their ultimate outcome will not be so good as it is required.
Good, sir. So finally, sir, I would like to have your last comments here today. Rather, for research scholars who are starting their career in academic and research,
right,
what should be the starting and utmost important point for going into the field of the academic writing, because they are starting the academic writing with their thesis? So what would be the first priority for them?
I always believe 21st century is changing like anything, you know. So I always rarely said, you know, that if you are unable to take use of advantage of you know, the technology and science, then you will be at a back seat. So you have to take advantage of it. And I am not very you know, and I say that you be the victim or the you know, the slave of the technology and science, but you have to take it advantage. If something is, suppose you are not able to walk on your feet properly, and if there is a stick to hold your you know, balance, you must take that you know, stick, and precisely if it is scientifically made, it's more good for all of you. So technology and science is fantastic thing. Any impossible thing you can do with that. And I will give one example of science person who is the father of modern science, Stephen Hawking. He was on the wheelchair, but he was able to do such a fantastic research.
So thank you, sir. And we are adapting your inputs rather in our courses. We are going through the literature management tools and all that, the things put together. So we are very glad, we are very excited to have your expert comments. So I think these expert comments will help a lot to our learners, the faculty members, researchers who are enrolled in our course. Thank you, sir.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you.